Kingsgate Consolidated CEO and Managing Director Jamie Gibson joins me now to talk through the progress being made at the Chatree Gold Mine in central Thailand. Jamie, nice to meet you.
Hi, Jonathan, and great to be with you again today. Thank you for the opportunity.
It's a pleasure. Now, Jamie, before we look at what's happening at Chatree, and there's a lot to unpack there, can you give me a quick overview of the company and what you're trying to achieve?
Yes, sure. Jonathan, Kingsgate, it's been around. We're an ASX-listed gold company. We've been around since the 1980s, and we have a principal asset, which is the Chatree Gold Mine in Thailand. We've been exploring up there since the 80s. Chatree was founded in the 90s. It was brought into production in the early 2000s, and it operated successfully until 2016. We had a timeout. We did have a dispute with the Thai government, which we've been able to successfully resolve, I'm pleased to say. And just to give you a little bit of context on it very briefly, when it was operating in 2016 or up to 2016, it had produced close to 2 million ounces of gold and close to 10 million ounces of silver. And it's located in the middle of the Loei Fold Belt, which is a very large gold belt in the Indochina region. Starts up in Laos, bends through Thailand and down into Cambodia. And I'm pleased to say that we're the only Australian company there. We've got our foot on all the best bits, and we certainly want to continue to grow and make Kingsgate one of the premier mid-tier gold producers in Australia again.
So, Jamie, just out of interest, what's it like working in Thailand?
Look, we love it, Jonathan. It's a fantastic place. Look, in terms of mining jurisdictions, it's not what they would call a hardship destination, and certainly the people are our best asset, and it's a beautiful asset and to have. Where we are is we are located in central Thailand, so about 300 kilometres north of the capital, Bangkok. And it's very hot working conditions. It's monsoonal, so we manage the rain as well. But we've got a really highly skilled, highly educated workforce, and we've been able to make those conditions work to our advantage. And at the moment, we've got about 500 staff as we're continuing to build. And I'll talk a little bit more about the ramp up of operations shortly. Mm.
So, yeah, let's get to that. There's significant announcement earlier in the month with the recent permitting of plant number one. What's the expected impact of that on the company and your production goals moving forward?
Yes, look, that's a great question. And that's a really big deal for us. So when Chatree was originally built, it had one processing plant, this one, and it had a rated capacity of about 2.3 million tonnes. That was back in 2001. In 2011, we built another plant that sits right next to it. So there are two parallel plants. It was rated at 2.7 million tonnes per annum. So about 5 million tonnes all up. We got the newest plant back operating last year. This one that we've just reopened in May was the older one, so it took a little bit more work. But now that we've got it open and we're going through the commissioning stages of it, what it means is that we can get back up well over that 5 million tonnes processing per annum. We want to get it well over 6. It will really boost our bottom line. It'll get us back into that steady state production of greater than 100,000 ounces per year, which is a really great thing in this really strong commodity price environment that we're in at the moment.
And in terms of work, what do you need to do to get to that target?
Yeah, look, not much more, thankfully, Jonathan. So we've been going through the commissioning stages and, without sort of getting a little too technical on it, we go through the dry commissioning, the wet commissioning, and we'll be saying a little bit more about that to the market later this week. But so far, the initial tests have been proving to be very good. The plant, both the mills are operating well, the processing circuit, everything's exactly where it should be. So we're very excited. And maybe to give you a benchmark to compare it to, when we reopened plant number two, the newer one last year, we had a commissioning estimation of about 3 months, but we got it back up to sort of over 3 million tonnes per annum within about 4 weeks. And we're hoping that plant one can do something similar this time. And certainly early signs are very positive.
And Jamie, it's not the only thing going on. You have a relationship with Akara, who are working on Chalawan and the Kumpi prospects. Can you talk us through that relationship? And there were results yesterday as well.
Yeah, correct. And look, we love this as one of our most exciting parts. As you know, a mine's only as good as its future ore feed, I suppose. And, I guess relating back to my earlier comments, we're right in the middle of a large belt. We're the only ones there as part of our sort of comeback. We were given access to a whole range of these exploration areas. And what makes Chalawan and Kumpi so good for us is they're very close to the processing plant, 2 to 3 kilometres at best, so easily trucking distance. They'll be the first areas that we look to vend into a new mining license. But what I guess from a geological and certainly from an operational perspective, what's good about it for us is the gold intersections that we're getting are near surface, you know, almost from the surface itself down to that sort of sweet spot, 50 to 100 meters, which makes them easy to get. We're getting really good single double digit gold intersections. We're getting good silver intersections. And what it's showing us, or what it's confirming for us, is that we think the Chatree system repeats down this southeastern corridor, which is where they are, and all signs are pointing at the moment that it does.
So those two prospects there, they can really help you enhance the overall value and the lifespan at Chatree.
Yes, correct. And maybe to put a little bit more context around it. So Chatree is a low-grade operation. So our point head grade, our gold head grade, has been around the sort of 0.8 to 0.9 grams per tonne traditionally, obviously a little bit higher at certain periods. And we are expecting that going forward again now. But certainly, these will be the first new areas that we want to, you know, vend into a mining lease, so we continue to feed our two big hungry plants. And certainly we see it as the first area that we'll continue to expand.
And just finally, Jamie, you've touched on some of the points as we've spoken, but what is next for the company?
Look, we want to continue to grow, Jonathan. Look, we've had a few years out, I guess through those years, you know, the company did very well to survive and to get back where it's got. And now I've got what we like to say, a lot of blue sky in front of us. You know, our market cap's pushing up around the $500 million mark again. We've seen good capital gains in the share price for our long-term investors. We've got a lot of optionality around the Chatree Gold Mine, both within the mine itself, you know, within the existing mining footprint, the A-pit, which is where we are. We could be mining there 4 to 5 years without having to do anything else. Chalawan and Kumpi are showing excellent results just outside the fence. We know that trend continues further along. So we'll be pulling out all stops to grow this. And we're only limited by the amount of resources we can put into it. But beyond that, silver price, gold price is going very well. We have another asset in South America as well that we're having a good hard look at, particularly with silver around $30 US. So we want to get back to being one of Australia's premier gold and silver producers. And I think we can do that. And that's certainly our short-term vision. And we're putting all of our effort into getting back there.
Jamie, good luck with that vision. And thanks for your time.
Thanks, Jonathan. Great to chat to you today. Thank you.